Henry Greener here reporting for the Shtick from the Melbourne Hebrew Congregation.
What we've just seen on the screen then was the original introduction to Shalom TV, which was the show on Channel 31 before the Shtick came along.
Tonight on the Shtick we have with us George Smilovici.
This week's special guest on the Shtick is Pinchas Silich.
We have with us Mr. John So.
This week on the Shtick we have with us as a special guest Tracy Bartram.
Hello.
This week we have with us as a special guest David Ha'ivri. And David's from Israel. He's visiting Melbourne at the moment. Hello, David.
Hi, Henry.
How are you going?
I'm doing good.
Anyone who's done a film, even no matter how bad a film it is.
Yeah. Tell me, what was the hardest thing you guys had to overcome when you made your films? Was there like a hurdle that was somewhat insurmountable at the time and you eventually got through?
Most of the things that we did, I guess, was fall under that category. I guess the hardest thing was just the fact that no one really had any experience doing it.
It's the same dramas, it's just more of them, that's
yeah,
all.
Yeah.
Okay.
I imagine.
But the satisfaction at the end, it's pretty...
Yeah, we raised the money completely privately between the secular community, the Jewish community, the Arab community. I mean, we have like the United Nations of investors.
So nice. you solved the Middle East problem now through your movie.
We have solved the Middle East problem.
Not yet. People want to get paid. And then we'll see what happens after.
Yeah, in fact, we went to Dubai Film Festival in November and then went over to Damascus in December with one of the investors, to the horror of my mother. Yeah. You're going to Syria.
So I recall Simon's storytelling.
No, wait.
Oh, my phone's ringing.
My phone. Say one of my favorite shticks.
Candy!
Can she come now?
We're at the Shtick filming. Oh. We're actually in the middle of filming right now. Yeah.
The camera's rolling.
And
it's
now,
perfect timing.
It's rolling, and yeah. Now this phone conversation.
Tell us some of your favorites.
Yeah, what's your favorite clip from the Shtick?
Put it next to the microphone.
What's your favorite clip from the Shtick? Quick.
Have you got a mic?
Storytelling. That was pretty cool.
What one? Sorry, repeat it.
Ah, we forgot about the bargain hunting.
Well, we'll have to do that one. Hooray,
Welcome to Story Time for Children. Today's story, Never Ever. Never was a small boy who had a sister whose name was Eva. And when they would walk to school, the people would cheer out. They would all together call, "There's Never Ever running about." Never and Eva would smile and wave, behaving in such a delightful way. One day a man they had not seen before stopped and smiled and said, "Bonjour." He bent down and asked, as he was frightfully tall, "What are your names, children? Would you like a ball?" And together they answered, "Never, ever." The tall man, thinking this must be a joke, smiled and said again, "Now I'm not a dumb bloke. It's just your names that I seek from you young folk." The children smiled and said together, "Never, ever. How's the weather?" The tall man went slightly red and decided that he must lie in bed. And so he went back home that, oddly enough, was shaped like a dome. The children went back to their walk and along the way met a dog who could talk. "Excuse me," he said, politely trained, "but do tell me what are your names. I think there's a chance that it might possibly rain." Together the children both smiled and said, "Never ever. Shouldn't you be in bed?" The dog then replied, "There's always a chance of rain, but your names, please tell me again." The children sighed and together replied, "Never ever, isn't it cold outside?" The dog thought for a while until he said, "Never say never, it might last forever." But the weatherman, he did say, that there's the slightest chance that it might rain with clouds coming in from the bay. With that, a crack of thunder fell from the clouds, and the children and dog ran inside the nearest house. "It's just like I said," the dog announced, going red. "Never say never, now it's off to bed." But before he left, he just wanted to know, "Your names," he pleaded, "I really must know." And together the children smiled and replied, "Never ever," and laughed until they cried.
All the lights, just easy as ABC, that's how we make it right. Open to the way you move is amazing.
Well, that's another fine mess you've gotten us into.